thousands of gallons of crude oil are oozing into the Louisiana coastal.
Make no mistake. We will do whatever's necessary.
But in effect, this is a crisis.
I'm just a commercial fisherman. My whole life is based on this.
Have we brought in the best and the brightest of all the minds that could deal with this?
Team ELASTEC. We're from Carmi, Illinois. We've been in the oil spill business for 20 years. We've got over 100 employees now, so it's a big, big family now.
We build oil spill recovery equipment. We're the largest manufacturer in the U.S. and definitely a contender in the world.
We export to over 100 countries.
We go out in the field and actually make our equipment work ourselves.
So in the 20 years we've been manufacturing equipment, we work in many spills, Russia, China, South America.
We were on the Gulf of Mexico during the Deepwater Horizon incident. There was about 300,000 barrels of oil that we eliminated, so we've been around the business for a while.
So when we heard of this XPRIZE challenge, certainly anybody in the industry is going to recognize that's a pretty high mark to hit.
When we first started, I got to admit, we said, well, we don't know if we can do this.
2,500 gallons a minute was, I felt, was unreachable. You know, nobody's going to do that.
We like challenges, and this certainly was a challenge. We've been building skimmers with grooves on drums.
We just moved our groove technology onto a disc and gave it a shot.
We built a single disc prototype.
This is the first time it's ever been shown. The first time. We have a disc with grooves on one side, and then it's a smooth surface on the other side.
And we were all just amazed what it did.
You can see the recovery rate on the right-hand side is much higher than the recovery rate on the left-hand.
We rigged up just a very quick little hydraulic motor to be able to spin it in the oil and then actually just set scrapers up onto it and filled up a 32-gallon garbage can in 35 seconds or something like that. That was the eureka moment for me anyway.
You're not just improving the surface area, you're actually making a channel that the oil will want to adhere to, what we call a meniscus effect. It's kind of a capillary thing. It's almost like a vacuum that's pulling that into the groove and allows us to spin at very high RPMs. So we can spin faster than competitors and we're capturing more oil than competitors.
This is the largest skimmer we've ever built.
I've never ordered at one time, I don't think I've ever ordered so much material for one particular project.
In our world, 90 days to build something from concept is pretty challenging. So we pulled out all the stops. We have rather deep infrastructure. We have 140 employees, our own fabrication shops, our own machine shops. So we're able to pull this sort of thing off. But it took a lot of resources, a lot of overtime.
It was late nights and early mornings. And
it wasn't just for us to build, but to pull in all of our vendors.
We've got technologies here that's never been used before in any other device.
You're ready, right? Set. We're ready anytime.
We're hooked up. This is Todd over here. We can start up.
We're told we can start. Okay, at speed.
Like we planned.
We were running the troughs over from the beginning to the end.
I had to
know what.
I had to back.
That all looked good.
Oh yeah.
For me, I've never seen a machine pick up so much oil in one. It's remarkable. In 30 years, I've never seen one do so much oil.
If we can get 3 runs like that, we'll be happy.
Yeah.
Actually, we'll forget.
Nice 6 runs.
You never count our chickens before they hatch. So the wave action is going to be the biggie.
Waves are on their way. Okay, we're up to speed. We got to go, Jeff. Okay, pop.
Get much better than this.
I think right now we're the team to beat, and we've probably raised the bar quite a bit, and so we'll see how it goes.
Failure's not an option. We didn't come here for second place.